When the Hoover Dam was built, it was said to make the desert bloom and was described as an incredible engineering feat and a godsend to the entire Southwest. But in recent years, the dam had become something of a liability and a bottleneck. From its vulnerability to terrorist attacks threatening the electricity and water supply for a large section of the Southwest, to forcing burgeoning passenger and freight highway traffic to either be detoured or endure significant crossing times, the dam needed a made-to-order solution. Enter the Hoover Dam Bypass Project, consisting of the 1,900-foot-long Mike O'Callaghan Pat Tillman Memorial Bridge and the 3.5 miles of approach on both sides of the river, in addition to 8 other bridges. A project 40 years in the making, it has made tremendous inroads to improving driver and pedestrian safety, reducing travel time and fuel consumption for motorists traveling between Las Vegas and Phoenix, and bolstering the economy by restoring a critical trade route disrupted following 9/11. The $240 million project was completed on original budget without dispute or claim. The jewel in this crown is, of course, the bridge crossing itself, the highest and longest arched concrete bridge in the Western Hemisphere, featuring the world's tallest precast concrete columns. Using high-strength, locally produced 10,000 pounds per square inch concrete for the twin arch ribs, the efficiency of the concrete-steel hybrid design shortened the construction schedule and kept costs in check. The enormous challenges imposed by the harsh environment were overcome by innovations in construction as well as technology. From the use of 2,500-foot cableways and a 13.5-ton trolley and load block assembly, to pouring concrete mid-air at night and using surveying and monitoring systems to analyze the impact of several variables on construction. The American Society of Civil Engineers is proud to recognize the Hoover Dam Bypass Project as an OCEA finalist.